check in the Philippine stock exchanges. Closing numbers now. The local bourse fails to sustain gains in the last two sessions. The PSE's main index shed 0.1% to close at 62.46. Value turnover was also lower at 2.3 billion pesos. Now, stocks are down, but stock prices now seem to be comfortable in the 6,200 zone. Many investors are hoping such a rise can be sustainable. Let's ask Regina Capital's Jerry Alfonso her analysis of this market. Hello, Jerry.
Hi, Stan.
Yeah, good to have you here. Now, today's ending numbers at 62.45 is a pullback that seems to be acceptable, at least, given how we've breached the tough 6,200 resistance lately. Are you seeing that this is it? This is the road to the Santa Claus rally everyone's hoping for.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah, we had a little bit technical correction today from the prior rallies. On the monthly basis, we are actually having a great run in November. In our house, we are optimistic on the Christmas rally. And looking at the chart, there are no signs that the momentum is exhausted. We are now nearing the 100-day MA, which kind of acted as a strong barrier in the whole second half of the year. But we are now looking to break that significant 100-day MA MA line. Mm-hmm. And in our view, we could easily get past by the 6,300 level as we are plotting our resistance at the 6,400. And we are not seeing any major negative catalyst that could drag the index down by year end. Market drivers that we are seeing in the next couple of weeks will be the MSCI and FTSE rebalancing, as well as the BSP's interest rate decision. And in FTSE, it's a good thing that the Philippines has a net inflow, and we think that the BSP will maintain the key policy rates.
Okay, so you said it could easily go up to 6,300. What about support? What is the immediate support we have to look out for in order for this trend not to break?
We are looking at the 6,000.
Okay. So it's still 6,000.
Yeah, that's the stronghold.
Okay, now the latest Fed comments was such a downer for markets yesterday. Have markets regained their composure today? Although we know for a fact that trading has been lean for most of our markets, even in the US, because of the Thanksgiving break.
Mm-hmm. Well, after the Fed comments, it is likely that the rates will still stay elevated for longer. This is not entirely surprising, as the Fed has always remained hawkish. We think investors seem to have shrugged this off, since we saw the U.S. market open higher. So the market didn't really react to it.
Okay, let's talk about oil prices now. Prices falling following the delay of the OPEC Plus meeting, where consensus is supposed to have been reached on the directions they are taking as regards oil production. Now, is this market pricing this in for cooler inflation numbers, at least for this month?
We could expect oil prices to fall further. We did see oil fall below the 80 per barrel level.
Yeah.
And that's the lowest price since July amidst the supply and demand concerns in US and in China. Oil still fell despite the news of a potential production cuts. Mm-hmm. We could see oil prices decline as investors await for OPEC to make a decision. And it is likely that the delay has been due to the OPEC members disagreeing with the production levels.
Yeah.
And as oil continues to decline, we should expect a cooler inflation.
Okay, and of course, with cooler inflation, we look to gross domestic product for 2023 in the latest Pilipinas conference this week. Finance Secretary Benjamin Diokno remains confident 2023 GDP targets will be between 6 to 7%. And that is still reachable less than 2 months before we close the year. Now, do you have house consensus for GDP at Regina, and is it in line with governments?
Mm-hmm. Our house consensus for GDP at Regina is at 6.5%, and it is between the national government's target range, which aligns with Finance Secretary Benjamin Diokno's confidence in the government's 2023 GDP target of between 6 to 7%. This indicates a shared expectation that the economic performance is on is on track to meet the government's projected range. And this is supported by the sustained government spending as well as the expected improvement in private consumption amid the holiday season and the receding price pressures.
Okay, let's talk about equity investments now, Jerry. The PSE is saying it expects four big IPOs in 2024, one of which, of course, is SM REIT, which has deferred its debut this year due to unfavorable market sentiments. Now, do you have hints, at least hints, as to the other three, if not the actual names, at least the sectors that they belong to?
Well, we still have to wait for further announcement regarding that matter, but hints, we think... two of those IPOs will be on the infrastructure sector, and then two will be on the property sector, SM REIT included.
All right. So lastly, what is your feel of investor sentiment for next year? Are you expecting marked improvement in terms of interest in IPOs, and what company attributes perhaps are investors looking for in any new offer?
Here, we hold a positive outlook for 2024. Most likely, there will be a smaller drag from monetary tightening. Our expectation is that both the Fed and the BSP will keep policy rates high. There's a possibility that the Fed could increase the benchmark rates furthermore, but we think we are now at the peak or near the peak. When it comes to the rate cuts probably won't arrive until the second half of 2024. But the idea of a rate cut alone materializing in 2024 could be a strong boost in equities. And with that, investors' confidence towards IPOs could be boosted as well. And to your other question, the attributes that investors are looking for in IPOs, it's always one thing, IPOs with a great story.
All right, it's the narrative, really. Again, Jerry Alfonso of Regina Capital Development Corporation, thanks for the market insight. Talk to you again soon.
Thank you, Stan. Have a great day.